I can do good as well, you know, whatever tad bit that I can do.
It is very necessary to have a very frank counseling.
I think the work that we do, it's very real. You can see that it's sort of answering a very real need.
Inner satisfaction I would get only when I do something which I can start and which I can continue.
Lot of hurdles to cross if you want to sustain yourself in social space.
Every minute is a challenge for us.
Ramakrishna Reddy Kumita. I'm currently working as an assistant professor at Center for Social Entrepreneurship, Tata Institute of Social Sciences, Mumbai. We provide three different things. One is mentoring. Mentoring is considered to be very crucial. And the second one is space, office spaces, physical space at Tata Institute of Social Sciences. And then third one is the support capital that I was referring to you earlier, as well as seed capital that helps them to build their organizations. I would say 40% of them would start a social enterprise, and we are expecting, since recently we got a partnership with the DBS Bank Singapore where we promote these ventures. What happens, TIS being a public funded institutions, we do have a reservation policy being implemented, and then half of our students come from deprived backgrounds. So we have to once they graduate, there's a lot of, and then being most of the students, you know, come from first generation educated backgrounds, and then families certainly do expect a lot from these students, and we provide support capital for these students. Every month we give them a stipend for 3 years after they graduate from the program, so that their personal needs as well as families' needs will be taken care. A batch of students, three students, Devartha Banerjee, Jayant, and Ritvik, they have started venture and waste management. One of the students in Gujarat by name Ketan Parmar, he's working in organic farming. And the other student is Ramana Babu Kille. He's working in Andhra Pradesh on mechanization of agriculture. And then other student, he works on education in Orissa. So they work on multiple areas, wherever the social problem comes from in different parts of the country. As a policy matter, we do not promote placements. Though TISS as an institution has a strong placement record, as a center, we at the center level have decided that we are not going to promote placements. And we believe strongly in social entrepreneurship being employment creation rather than employment seeking. So that's the intention. And apart from that, we want our students to address social problems. And then I do go quite often to deliver various lectures at different colleges to promote the field of social entrepreneurship. It's up to the students whether they are interested in the field or not. And then as someone who entered into the field at the early level, I feel it's my responsibility to, you know, promote the field in terms of informing the students that there is a field by name social entrepreneurship, and then this is what social entrepreneurship is all about. So if anyone of you are really interested, you can come forward and then ask me or, you know, those who are into the field of social entrepreneurship, so that they'll get further information, and whoever is interested will be certainly pursued. The key issues that we develop within the students is the leadership qualities, and foremost is understanding societies and communities, where they'll have to go back and understand the problems that the people face and then work with the communities. So understanding society and communities becomes one of our critical issues that we teach students, because what happens many students come from urban backgrounds who do not have any, you know, understanding about rural problems or social problems as such, few of them. So in order to give a glimpse of what exactly is, you know, happening at the grassroots or at various social dimensions. We give them understanding of society and communities, and then we develop leadership qualities among them. We have leadership courses on leadership, and then apart from that, we develop them as great managers as well, managers who would lead these organizations once these organizations have been built up. And as has mentioned, we also develop them managerial skills and then financial skills, where they could organize or manage their own organizations.